My name is Gladys Morrison. I am in the lab of Dr. Eileen Dolan. My research is mainly trying to find neuroprotective agents for peripheral neuropathy, and it is a debilitating toxicity in breast cancer patients who are receiving chemotherapy. And so our main goal is to try to find drugs or neuroprotective agents that can protect peripheral neurons which are affected by chemotherapy. Okay, so I'm originally from Ghana. I moved to Worcester, Massachusetts when I was in high school. And then went to college in Atlanta, Georgia at Spelman College, and went to grad school at Baylor College of Medicine in Houston, and decided to come here for my fellowship. I've always been interested in sort of science, but then it mainly started off when I found out my mom had breast cancer when I was much younger. And so that sort of moved me into researching more as to what causes breast cancer and how certain women, why certain women get breast cancer and what are the different types of breast cancer and stuff like that. So breast cancer patients are oftentimes given chemotherapy, which is a cytotoxic drug, and the side effects of that most of the time is peripheral neuropathy, which causes patients to feel pain in their peripheral extremities and prevents them from feeling cold or heat, etc. And so due to the recent advances in induced pluripotent stem cells, we are now able to create tissue-specific cell types in which toxicities occur. So with this in vitro model, we are then able to screen for possible neuroprotective agents that can prevent or overcome the chemotherapy-induced toxicity that we see in patients. And so with these drugs, we can then translate them into the clinic to eventually or hopefully find neuroprotective agents that can overcome these toxicity neuropathies that we see in patients. More and more physicians are realizing that personalized medicine is the way to curing or understanding the etiology of any disease. And so I came to this lab to try to understand how to investigate the different causes or the different variants that each individual possess, which then results in us all responding very differently to therapies or to drugs. And so at the end of the day, overall, if we're able to achieve that, that would definitely increase the chances of survival and reduce mortality rates. For anyone who is interested in this field, I would say that I think you can do it. It's not an easy road, but there are always these moments of satisfaction or excitement and happiness that sort of make it all worthwhile. I think you can definitely do it if you put your mind to succeeding, or if this is really something that you want to do, just try, and try again. If you don't succeed, just keep trying.